स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मिस रचना जैन, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, गवर्नमेंट पीजी कॉलेज राजगढ़ अलवर। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू द पोएम ए प्रेयर फॉर माई डॉटर विच इज़ इन द सिलेबस ऑफ बी ए पार्ट थर्ड इंग्लिश लिटरेचर पेपर फर्स्ट यूनिट ए। दिस इज माई सिक्स्थ वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन दिस पोएम A Prayer for My Daughter, composed by W.B. Yeats. Students, this is the seventh stanza of the poem A Prayer for My Daughter. First of all, I read the stanza for you. My mind, because the minds that I have loved, the sort of beauty that I have approved, prosper but little, has dried up of late, yet knows that to be choked with hate may well be of all evil chances chief, if there is no hatred in a mind, assault and battery of the wind can never tear the linnet from the leaf. Now I explain you the hard meanings of the words mentioned in the poem. Approved means supported. Prosper means thrive or develop. Choked with hate means overwhelmed with hatred or full of hatred. Assault means attack. Battery means also attack. And the total line, assault and battery of wind, means misfortunes, strokes of misfortunes and sufferings of life. Now, I tell you the reference with context of these lines. These lines have been taken from the poem A Prayer for My Daughter, composed by W.B. Yeats. In this poem, the poet is anxious for the safety of his newborn child, Annie Butler Yeats, in the world which is growing more and more anarchic and troublesome. The child is sleeping innocently through a howling storm. The screaming sea winds are rising from the Atlantic Ocean. The great problem in the poet's mind is how to protect the innocent child from the wrath of the coming tides. The poet becomes gloomy and prays for his daughter. The poet praises courtesy, charm, wisdom, and the good manners. He wants his daughter to be free from the hatred, especially intellectual hatred. He says that courtesy is to be preferred to the perfection of physical charms. The poet father prays that the soul of his daughter may grow and reach self-fulfillment like a flourishing tree. He prays that cheerful and innocent thoughts may cluster round her soul as do linnets round a tree. May she be herself happy and contented and a source of happiness for others. So in these lines, the poet prays God to free his daughter from the feeling of intense hatred which ruins mankind. Now I explain you the stanza. In these lines, the poet peeps into himself and feels that he has developed too much of hatred. The sorts of minds and beauty do not flourish in life because they are embracing hatred. His mind has also dried up with hate. To repose hatred in one's heart, he thinks, is the chief evil. The poet is confident that if there is no hatred in mind of Linnet, the bird, the howling and the shrieking winds do not separate the linnet from the tree. The idea is that harmony can prevail only if there is no hatred. The poet wants that his daughter Annie Butler Yeats should consider strong opinions detestable things. He has seen the fate of a most beautiful woman, Madgon, belonging to a well-to-do family, who, because of her strong opinions about herself, others, life and politics, lost her happiness. She sacrificed her prosperity and all her good qualities appreciated by her quiet admirers for becoming an out-of-date revolutionary orator full of words in freedom and in favor of violent action with freedom for Ireland. She gained nothing. This is a reference to Madgon, whom the poet loved. She had refused to marry Yeats. So the poet wants that his daughter Annie should not be the object of such aimless wanderings, both physical and spiritual, as have been the fate of his father, the poet. So the poet's mind has been too full of hatred, and this hatred has choked the springs of life in his heart. The poet wishes that there should be no hatred in his daughter's mind, for a mind free from hatred cannot be overcome by any buffets or strokes of misfortune. Thus, the poet wants his daughter to develop such qualities of character and manners as will help her to live in a world full of troubles. This is the 8th stanza of the poem. An intellectual hatred is the worst, so let her think opinions are accursed. Have I not seen the loveliest woman born out of the mouth of plenty's horn, because of her opinionated mind, bartered that horn and every good by quiet natures understood for an old bellows full of angry wind? Now I explain you the difficult words in simple English. Accursed. Accursed means suffering from a curse or detestable. Plenty of horns means goat's horn, which is said to be a symbol of prosperity and happiness. Opinionated means suffering from prejudices. Barter, exchange, quiet, peaceful, bellows, an instrument for blowing fire. Now I explain you the reference with context. The poet becomes gloomy and prays for his daughter. He finds that the world is heading towards anarchy. The poet thinks that certain qualities of heart and mind can help her daughter, his daughter, to protect herself. The poet praises courtesy, charm, wisdom, and good manners. He thinks that hatred, especially intellectual hatred, is the worst quality of character. It spoils one's heart and mind. The poet looks into his own mind and heart and finds such have been the experiences of his life, and such was the beauty he loved, hatred within himself. He regards hatred as the worst of all evils and prays that his daughter should be free from this evil. If there is no hatred in the soul, then no strokes of misfortune can ruin the innocence and cheerfulness of a person. So in these lines, the poet discusses some of the positive qualities he finds his daughter to possess. Now I explain you the lines of this stanza. The poet wishes that his darling daughter Annie Butler Yeats should avoid the faults of Mordgon, whom he loved too much. Intellectual hatred is the worst kind of hatred, and so he would like his daughter to have no strong opinions. It was owing to her strongly held opinions that Mordgon acted so foolishly. She was so beautiful and so well born, and yet she ruined her happiness and her chances of success in life by marrying John McBride, a worthless, vain, glorious lout. The poet wants that his daughter should be free from intellectual hatred, which he regards as the worst kind of hatred. The poet gives the reference of Mordgon, whom he has seen, that Mordgon went astray only because she had a prejudiced mind and preconceived likes and dislikes. Otherwise, she could be said to be a woman born out of the horn of plenty. She bartered away that gift and everything else considered good by quiet natures. She exchanged an old bellow, which is nothing but full of wind, for the horn of plenty. In other words, it was only for the sake of her political purposes that she changed her choice. Instead of accepting W.B. Yeats' proposal, she married merely ordinary man John McBride, a worthless, vainglorious lout, full of sound and fury signifying nothing. Therefore, Yeats wishes that his daughter should have no strongly held opinions. Opinions make women opinionated, obstinate, and unreasonable. The opinionated Mordgon, the loveliest woman, acted so obstinately and so irrationally in marrying McBride and ruined her own happiness and that of the poet. So, the poet thinks that intellectual hatred is the worst kind of hatred, and so his daughter should not have such kind of intellectual hatred in herself. That's all for the day. Thank you for listening to my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.